Well, let's get another reaction to the story. You're now joined by attorney Nery Colmenares. He is chairman of Bayan Muna and also serves as legal counsel for the families of some of the drug war victims. Attorney Colmenares, nice to see you. Welcome to the program. Thanks for joining us today.
Thank you, Carmina. A good day to all your viewers.
All right, so let's get on with this discussion. How would you describe this declaration of unequivocal defense of the former president coming from your colleagues at the lower house, former colleagues at the lower house, Attorney Colmenares?
Well, that's the problem, because I think the resolution, especially if it's approved by majority of the members, will only show the ICC that justice against former President Duterte is inaccessible in the Philippines. The problem with this insinuation about there's no evidence, the Philippine courts are functioning. The only question that is asked by the victims is, kinakasuhan niyo ba si Duterte dito? Iniimbestigahan niyo ba siya? Eh, wala eh. Hindi eh. So how can they even assert that there is no evidence when they're not investigating? Hmm. So, I mean, the ex-president threatened, not only threatened, sabi niya, I will kill drug suspects. Then his police killed about 6,181 drug suspects, although they claim na nandaban. But they still killed it, the suspects. And then after that, President Duterte said, I will immunize you, that's his term. I will make sure you don't go to prison, protect you, everything. Is it not even at the very least probable cause for the DOJ to investigate? Mm. I thought they have an executive order to investigate extrajudicial killings and media killings. But no, they didn't. So all this thing about, you know, the justice system is working here, they cannot even prove or even show that ex-President Duterte is being investigated or prosecuted only strengthens the case in the ICC, because that is a clear sign that the victims here cannot access justice in the Philippines, and that's why they have to resort to the International Criminal Court.
Attorney Colmenares. Well, my second, go ahead.
Well, my second point is this. Why are they spending all these government resources and pronouncement with the Solicitor General and the DOJ Secretary of filing appeals, lawyering for President Duterte? He is an ex-president, a powerful person, a very rich person, and a lawyer at that. They don't even have funds for legal services for the poor. Yung mahihirap dyan, hirap na hirap makakuha ng abogado. They will not even devote funds for the legal services to our OFW. But here comes a president, a former president, who is not even asking their help. Mm. he's a lawyer, diba? He is rich, diba? Mm. So why offer him legal services?
Precisely.
When you cannot even the same legal services to the poor.
Precisely my next question. I mean, it's very, I think it's very apt that I talk to you today, because not only are you representing some of the victims' families, but you were also at one point part of the House of Representatives. So real talk now, Attorney Colmenares, why do you think it was necessary for these lawmakers to come out with this declaration of support for the former president?
For me, Gloria Arroyo's leading this resolution is just payback for President Duterte's efforts to have her released from her hospital arrest because of her cases. That's just, you know, I'll scratch your back, you know. All this has got to stop, Carmina. The incumbent president, you know, frees the previous president. President Gloria Arroyo, of course, pardoned former President Estrada. And then President Aquino, of course, was the president when Gloria Arroyo was charged. And President Duterte facilitated her release. Now, under the new president, they're going to protect the former president. This is really, for me, this is really shameful if our justice system is being run just because, you know, the new president likes the former president or dislikes. For me, justice is on the merits, eh? Mm. Should not be on whether or not. So for me, it's just payback time for Gloria Arroyo to President Duterte, who helped her during her time of need when she was in prison. So yeah, I guess this resolution, I hope, does not carry the voice of the House, because the many of the victims, the thousands of victims, are the constituents of members of the House. Hmm. I mean, they're supposed to represent the ordinary people. And for me, to represent the ex-president against, of course, the constituents who are human rights violations victims or the families of the victims, for me, it's not really representing or being the voice of the poor in Congress. So, I hope it won't pass.
Jumping off from where you just left off, Attorney Colmenares, would you say that at the very least this is tone deaf? Because where were these voices, as you said, supposed to be representing the people when the deaths were mounting? Now, here you have some 19 lawmakers now voicing their unequivocal defense of the former president. But where were their voices then, when the deaths were mounting? Attorney Colmenares.
Correct. That's why one of the... If your constituents are being killed like chickens, so to speak, diba? I mean, one of the thing you need to do, or at least express concern. I mean, why... You see, Carmina, just a legal thing. There were 6,181 killed by the police, admitted by them. But they claim that it's self-defense. Under the case of Aguilar versus DOJ, the Supreme Court said, the moment the police kill somebody and admitted to killing somebody, the DOJ has no recourse but to prosecute. Why? What probable cause are you looking for? He already admitted to have killed the victim. So whether or not it's self-defense, it's up for the courts to decide, not for the DOJ. Mm. So dapat, out of 6,181 victims of AJK na nanlaban daw, there should have been 6,181 criminal cases against this police, and let the court decide whether nanlaban o hindi. It's evidentiary naman yan. Mm-hmm. But in terms of probable cause, the DOJ cannot dismiss any complaint on the ground na wala kaming probable cause. He admitted it eh. Mm-hmm. I killed the victim, nanlaban kasi. So only this shows that the victims here cannot have access to justice when now... Very few cases were filed against the police, even if they admitted to killing 6,181 victims in the AJK drug war.
So, Attorney Colmenares, if these voices were silent then, when the deaths were mounting, and now they're speaking up in defense of the former president, what does that tell you?
Well, that the system is not accessible to the poor, and that's stronger reason for the ICC to take jurisdiction of the case, because not only is the executive through the investigative agencies protecting the ex-president, but now even the legislative is protecting the ex-president. So the more reason that the ICC will now say, oh, that resolution only proves our point, that it's difficult. Imagine an ordinary person going against the ex-president and the executive right now and the legislative right now. Sino namang mahirap yung ordinaryong pamilya ka lang ng biktima ng EJK? Lalaban ka dyan? No. This is more reason. In fact, we'll probably send a copy of that resolution to the ICC and say, look, this is the reason why the people of the Philippines are going to you, because there's no justice to be had here. And President Duterte is not being investigated, nor is he prosecuted. Nagbibingi-bingihan ang executive, nagbibingi-bingihan ang legislative sa kasong ito.
But when you read the document, Attorney Colmenares, this is what they're saying, that the former president's administration, his presidency, has ushered in remarkable accomplishments. And this is brought about by his relentless campaign against illegal drugs, insurgency, separatism and terrorism, corruption in government and criminality, so on and so forth, thus making the life of every Filipino better, comfortable and peaceful. Your take on that,
yes.
Attorney Colmenares.
That is a fatal admission on their part. Actually, they're not denying that he was guilty. They are saying that the ends justify the means, because he made successes. So okay lang yung patayin mo, di ba? So, for me, that is the essence of the whereas clauses of the resolution. That they say, now, oh, look, he promised to campaign against drugs. And after that, we had a better life. As if it's true, but presuming it's true. So yeah, we'll defend him. So they're actually more or less admitting that he was guilty of that, but anyway, he succeeded in making our lives better. So yeah, the EJK there are good thing. It's a good thing. So maraming problem yung resolution na yan legally and politically, and I don't know why the ex-president Arroyo led the charge there, but anyway, they should consult lawyers if they are going to file resolutions like this. But yeah, it can even be used by the families of the victims in the ICC, if only to prove that President Duterte is really guilty of the crimes against humanity that was charged against him in the ICC.
So are you going to use this? Can this be considered as evidence in case the case moves forward? Because reading between the lines, you're saying this document, this declaration, has actually done the former president more harm than good.
Yeah, personally, I will tell the other lawyers, can we send this to the ICC now, if only to prove our point? Because for me, that's really damning also on the ex-president. That's the problem if you offer legal services to a person who's not asking for it. I mean, he's a proud person, ex-president Duterte, abogado ako, fiscal ako. He's always saying that. And then here you come along, magbibigay ka ng all government protection and full resources sa isang abogado, mayaman na, powerful pa, tapos wala kang pondo sa mahihirap. I mean, what kind of a justice system do we have here if we have such kind of, efforts on the part of the government to protect the ex-president rather than to protect the ordinary people who fell victims to his war on drugs?
And finally, talking about the justice system, the lawmakers once again reiterated what the Justice Secretary said, calling the resumption of the ICC probe insulting and unacceptable. The lawmakers in support of the former president Duterte included this in their declaration. And as you hear that, and knowing what you know, being one of the counsels of the drug war victims' families, what went through your head when you saw these words once again, saying that, reiterating that the resumption is insulting and unacceptable? Go ahead.
Actually, the stage in the ICC now is akin to a preliminary investigation here. Akin. Di naman parehong-pareho. But they're akin. So parang the prosecutor now is just finding out, investigating whether or not to file the information in the ICC. And here you go saying it's insulting for you. It's, you attack the prosecutor. Hindi ba si Piskal magagalit din? Nag-PPI lang ako dito. Tapos binira siya ng respondent. I mean, the fiscal will say, look, there's a complaint against you here. Can you submit your counter affidavit? Okay? So now the respondent will say, oh, you insult us. You're gagukayor. I mean, di ba magagalit yung fiscal, yung DOJ mismo? Sasabihin niya, ha? Nag-PPI lang ako. May complaint dito eh. I'm just doing my job. There's a complaint here. What can I do? Dismiss the complaint? Di ba magagalit naman yung complainant? So actually, the DOJ should be sympathetic to the prosecutor because that's merely a preliminary investigation, so to speak. And to attack the prosecutor only triggers more problems for you than resolving it. Di ba? So I don't know their tactic here. But I guess many of the fiscals here can sympathize really with the ICC prosecutor, if only because he's just doing what they're also doing here. And to be attacked by one of the parties merely because you're conducting an investigation based on a complaint is really unacceptable for the prosecutors. For the local DOJ fiscals here, unacceptable that they should be attacked by one of the respondents merely because they're holding a preliminary investigation and they're asking the respondent to submit his or her counter affidavit. That's the insulting part, actually, and the unacceptable part here, the attack against the prosecutor.
Bayan Muna Chairman Nery Colmenares there joining us this noon. Thanks again, Attorney Colmenares. Really appreciate you coming to the show to talk to us. Take care.
Thank you. Thank you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot.